This video is brought to you by Storyblocks. Big news, guys! Big news! A lot of things are currently happening at Cinecom. But it's all positive. You know, one of the things that we're currently working on is to make better content for you. So that's why we've put up a survey to which you can find the link to in the description below. Now, this survey will help us better understand who you are and what you want to see on this channel. At the same time, we're also doing a giveaway together with Storyblocks. In the last step of the survey, you can choose to enter the contest by leaving behind your email address. You can also skip this if you don't want that, but only if you do enter your email address, which we shall only use to tell whether you won or not, you'll have a chance to win a free year subscription at Storyblocks Video. For those who already have an active subscription, will just get an extra year for free. Now, the survey only takes about 1 minute to fill in and will be open until the 5th of November, and we would really appreciate any feedback that we can collect through it. Now, big news again. Adobe this time came out with a big update for most of its apps, including Premiere Pro. And for the first time in history, they finally listened to us. Now, this update is not packed with a ton of new features. There are, of course, a few, but it wasn't their main focus. They finally worked on performance and stability. So, with the new update, Premiere should not crash as often anymore or freeze up randomly. At least that's what they claim. We've been working in the beta version for several months now, and it did crash here and there. Of course, that was a beta version, so let's give the official update some time before we judge. Anyways, one of the biggest new features in Premiere Pro can be found within the Lumetri panel, and it sits under the Curves tab. You will notice that the big color wheel there is now gone, and we've got a bunch of new lines on which we can draw these curves. And here are 5 ways how you can actually use these curves in the real world, and I'm gonna start off with the normal RGB curves. But these were already there. The shot that we're going to work with looks pretty flat, and that's because it was recorded in a log format. Basically, what log does is lifting the shadows and pulling down the highlights to capture as much dynamic range as possible. So what we can do with the curves is the opposite. On the bottom, we can find the shadows, so Jenica's gonna pull that down. And the top right lays the highlights, which we're going to pull up. And see how we're creating an S-curve, which is a very healthy way to create contrast without crushing anything. You can also choose how much you need to pull the curves for the highlights and the shadows to preserve as much detail as possible. And this is almost as fast as the normal contrast slider, but you have a ton more control over the contrast. So this might be the first color correction. From the top in the Lumetri panel, there's now a drop-down menu. From here, we can rename the current Lumetri effect, and I'm gonna call it Basic Correction. Then going back into that drop-down menu, I will now add a new Lumetri color effect. And you know, let's name this one Skin Tones. With the first new curves feature, we can make a selection of the skin tones by simply clicking and adding points. In between, we're going to add a third point, which we can lift up to add more saturation or pull down to decrease the saturation. And this kind of works the same way as the HSL secondary, where you first select a specific color in your video, and then you can manipulate that. So by increasing the saturation for the skin tones, we're making it a bit more vivid or warmer, which is needed for Lorenzo, who's looking pretty dead in this example. The third curves option is called U versus Luma. Again, we're going to make a selection of the skin tone's color and lift up to make the face of Lorenzo brighter, making it pop out better within the scene. Now, if you are selecting other parts within your video, you can head over to your effects controls, locate the Lumetri effect called Skin Tones, and click on the Ellipse Mask tool. Place that over the face of your subject and feather it a bunch. The color adjustments that we've just done will now only be applied within that circle. Alright, let's add another Lumetri effect, and this time we're going to call it Sky Boost. We've got a beautiful sky, but we're going to make it pop out even better. In the U versus saturation curves, I'm gonna do the exact same thing as last time, but now select the blue and increase the saturation for it. If you're having trouble selecting the sky, probably because there's not enough blue in there, you can also go into the Luma versus saturation curve. The left side are the shadows and the right side are the highlights. So by pulling up the right side, we can add more saturation in the highlights, which is going to be the sky. Next up, the green bushes in the back do not look so interesting to me. So what I can do is head over to the U versus U, make a green selection and pull it to a different color. It's autumn, so the leaves should be red or brown. And by the way, guys, I'm constantly making manual selections. You can, of course, also use the color picker to make an automatic selection, but that never works so good. Usually the selection is too small, resulting in weird artifacts such as banding when you're going to make changes. And then the last thing that I'd like to show you guys is when you go back into the normal curves, we know that this here represents the luminance, but by clicking on either red, green, or blue on the top, we can change the luminance values for only that specific color. So if we click on the reds and pull down the shadows only, and if you want to bring back the highlights because this tool will always try to make curves, we can then make some interesting color shifts. Now we can remove some red from the shadows, making it more grungy, or add a little bit of red, making your shot more nostalgic and warm. A very quick way of creating custom gradings. Now I do have to mention that with everything that we've just seen, you need to be careful, do not overdo something. Usually subtle changes that still look natural can be much better than over-the-top gradings. And those were my 5 color grading tricks using nothing but the new curves inside Adobe Premiere Pro. Now a quick reminder that we have a survey and that we'd really appreciate any kind of feedback. Thanks to our sponsor Storyblocks, we are giving away 1-year subscription to one participant. For more information about all that, you can find a link to it in the description below. Thank you so much for watching. Thank you, Janik, for the screencasts. And like always... Janik! You're wearing a copycat t-shirt!
Isn't it Friday?
No, it's Tuesday, Janik!
My bad.